Task 4 starts off by telling us that the attacker is aware that we're starting to investigate them, and as a result, they've begun scrubbing some of their social media footprint. We're asked to look into their deleted content for further clues. In order to solve the questions in Task 4, we will return to the attacker's GitHub repository. Going up to the top of the profile, we can click on the repositories link to see all of the account's repositories. We're going to then click on the ETH repo and then the mining script file. If we look at this one line, there's not much information that we can use here. However, we can click on the history link here on the top right and see the edit history of this file. Clicking on the create mining script link will show us the original line that was created before the attacker edited it. The first flag we find here is the cryptocurrency wallet. So let's go ahead and copy this and paste it into the answer box. Next up, let's look at the mining pool the attacker was using to mine cryptocurrency. We can open up the mining pool's website here and see the cryptocurrency was the pool primarily mines. Simply copy this cryptocurrency and paste it in for yet another flag. For the last two flags, we need to look at the transactions that their cryptocurrency wallet has. We're going to paste the wallet into a blockchain explorer to view all the transactions for that particular wallet. Here, we can see the mining pool the attacker received payments from. We can copy that and paste that in for our third flag. And if we go back, we can also see the outgoing transactions, where the attacker transferred some of their cryptocurrency to a different type of crypto. Task 5 provides us with a new piece of information in the form of a screenshot depicting a message from the attacker's Twitter account. We're asked to use this screenshot to locate the attacker's Twitter account and use some of their tweets to find more information about their Wi-Fi SSIDs. To start off, we can right-click and open the image in a new tab. In this image, we're shown the attacker's old Twitter username, and we need to use that information to pivot and find their new Twitter name. We can find this new Twitter username by simply doing a search for the old name in Twitter. As you can see, the attacker made a previous tweet using their original username. Let's copy this username in and submit it for the flag. Next up, we need to locate the URL where the attacker saved their Wi-Fi SSIDs and passwords. If we scroll through their Twitter account, we eventually run across a relevant tweet here. Looking at the comments, we're given a clue that the screenshot is from the dark web, and based on the capitalized words, likely on the platform known as Deep Paste. So let's do a quick search for Deep Paste Dark Web to get the .onion URL. We can then scroll down to search Paste, and we're going to search by the MD5 hash that was shown in the attacker's Twitter screenshot. This will bring up the exact page we need that contains the Wi-Fi and password information. Copy the URL and paste it in for the flag. One thing to keep in mind is that this dark website will go up and down regularly, sometimes for extended periods of time. If the site is down or you simply are not comfortable with navigating through the dark web, the hint in this question will provide a screenshot that contains all the information you need to continue. And finally, we need to search for the BSSID that is related to the attacker's home Wi-Fi. If we navigate back to the paste, we can see the SSID for their home Wi-Fi. We can copy that, and we're going to search within Wiggle. And as you can see, it is a little bit difficult, but the dot over here in Japan is where our result actually is. If we zoom in far enough, we'll eventually see the SSID here on top, as well as the BSSID on the bottom. Enter this into the box and click Submit to complete Task 5. Task 6 tells us that the attacker is on the run and asks us to follow their trail back to their hometown. To start off, we need to head back to the Twitter account and locate the last photo they took before getting on their flight. We can throw this image into Yandex and crop the search area down to only the monument in the background. The results show us that the monument in the background is actually the Washington Monument in Washington, D.C. So if we search nearby for airports, we can see that the Ronald Reagan National Airport is the closest one to where this photo was taken. All that's left then is to look up the airport code, and we have our first flag. Next up, we need to identify where their last layover was. Navigating to another photo posted by the attacker, this time we're going to run a reverse image search using Google. We're given results that point us to Japan Airlines in Tokyo, but we still need to locate the specific airport. Let's click on one of these similar images here, and we're going to translate the page. This translation gives us the airport we're looking for, and if you look up the airport code for this airport, it's actually in the URL above. Let's copy that and paste it in to continue. We are also asked to identify the lake shown in another one of the attacker's Twitter photos. If we look closely, we also see this rather unique island here on the left side of the photo. Since we know the attacker's last layover was in Tokyo, Japan, let's go there as a starting point. We can then quickly see that the same island over here to the left, and zooming in, we're actually given the name of the lake, which we can type in for our flag. And for our final question, we're asked to identify where the attacker calls home. We know that the attacker's flight was heading north from Tokyo based on the photo of the lake. We also know by looking at the SSIDs previously that there was one titled Home Wi-Fi. If we go back and search this and wiggle again, we see the single result in northern Japan. We can then take the city name and enter it in for the final flag of this room.